see you to their office, that is the office of the New Hampshire Attorney General, for further comments and further developments. They also asked us to relay to you that they do not expect further developments probably until tomorrow morning. I realize that's probably not the news you folks have been waiting out here all day to hear, but unfortunately we are bound by the prosecutor's direction and judicial ethics in the state of New Hampshire. I would also like to point out that the media has been very helpful in the bigger picture here. There were descriptions of a vehicle that were broadcast during the investigation by Maine authorities, and it was those descriptions that led troopers to engage the person today. And I think that's as far as I probably should say.
So did the boy die in New Hampshire, Dave?
I can't comment on that. You'd have to ask the New Hampshire Attorney General on that.
Is she being charged with anything?
The person is not yet charged with a crime.
So how are you holding her here?
The person agreed to come back to be interviewed, and she that interview continues. And at this point, a determination was made that a medical evaluation was appropriate. She remains in custody for pendency of an ongoing investigation, but is not yet facing charges.
When you say a medical evaluation.
Right,
when you say a medical evaluation, is it a psychological evaluation? Has she taken ill here at the barracks?
All I'll say, it's a medical evaluation. I cannot be more specific.
Have any sort of attack? Is this a heart attack?
No.
Should she be taken to Emerson Hospital?
She's been taken to a nearby hospital.
For an evaluation, why is the advanced life support from Emerson?
I'm not sure what their typical response is for something like this. We requested a transport for a medical evaluation.
Is she on suicide watch of any kind?
I can't discuss that.
Can you just tell us why were troopers led by someone at the rest area to investigate this morning, or was it just a passing trooper who noticed the vehicle?
We were led there by a member of the public.
Someone that was. Can you describe? Because I know they were looking for this vehicle, and they put the word out through the public, through all of us. So
that's correct.
At 11 o'clock this morning, you received a call?
At 10:20 this morning, we received a call from a citizen who had seen prior coverage of this investigation and provided information that a vehicle of interest potentially was at the Chelmsford rest stop on the southbound side of the highway. We responded, several troopers there, and engaged that operator, a female adult operator, lone occupant of the vehicle, and that's why we're here now.
Was she arrested at gunpoint? Was she taken into custody at gunpoint? No. I mean, what's your protocol when you approach someone that might be involved in a serious crime?
They engaged her in conversation and brought her back here, and that's pretty much all I'm at liberty to say at this point.
Can you elaborate, though, that what led you to bring her here? Obviously, there must be some
statements. I cannot say whether there are statements or what specifically transpired. That's all part of an ongoing investigation, again, that the New Hampshire Attorney General has now taken control of.
Can you elaborate on the New Hampshire connection and why they are not involved?
I'd refer you to the New Hampshire Attorney General. The investigation has taken a development has occurred that has put the case under the direction of the New Hampshire Attorney General.
Did they look for anybody else? Other than this woman who is here today?
Massachusetts State Police or not, but you did have to direct that, Josh, to New Hampshire.
So basically, you have Massachusetts, New Hampshire, and Maine, three different agencies.
All in this building right now, yep.
But Massachusetts stands where in that investigation? Because you said you've handed everything over to New Hampshire, but wouldn't she be considered a fugitive from justice if she was wanted in connection with this crime?
If, in fact, New Hampshire does decide to seek charges, she would be.
So she can't just leave from the hospital and go?
She remains in the care and custody of Massachusetts State Police for the pendency of the ongoing investigation by New Hampshire. I'm not confirming any names, ages of the person who we have been in contact with. I'm not confirming any names of the victim or anything like that.
Is she the mother of this boy?
I'm not confirming any familial relationships or not.
Where do you go from here?
We're just, as I said, we're in custody of this person at this point. We're taking all precautions, as you can see, in terms of the medical evaluation. And again, we're going to take our direction from the New Hampshire Attorney General.
You expect the medical evaluation to be through the night and into tomorrow, and then you give us an update tomorrow on that status? Because we're obviously all anticipating that charges would be filed against this individual.
The, The next update will come from the New Hampshire Attorney General. It's potential that this will continue through the night, but I can't say for sure. That depends on the state.
What are Texas authorities planning?
Reading a Bible.
I can't say. I'm sorry.
What precipitated you to bring her to the hospital? Did she fall down and have a heart attack? Did she say,
no.
Did you, or was it initiated by the police?
It was initiated by Massachusetts State Police. It was not a critical medical emergency. There was a determination made that a medical evaluation would be appropriate at this time.
Can you tell us how Texas authorities are involved in this?
I'm sorry?
How authorities in Texas are involved in this?
I can't tell you that. I'm sorry.
Dave, his body was found in Maine, and she was discovered in Massachusetts. What does New Hampshire have to do with this case?
Beyond to say that the investigation... a development occurred during the investigation that required the involvement of New Hampshire. That's really all I can say, Steve. I'm sorry?
What point of the investigation did that development occur? The last hour? 4 hours ago?
Today. Today. I'm going to take about 2 more questions and I'm going to go because I really don't have anything further.
What's the worst that she confessed? Is that actually incorrect?
We would not comment on the nature of any kind of communications with the person in question.
The father? We have not heard about the father of this child. Has he been contacted? Is he involved in this?
I really can't discuss who else we're talking to. I'm sorry. Again, New Hampshire hasn't talked.
Based on what you've learned today, have you been able to definitively identify this little boy?
Investigators are in possession of a great deal of information that we cannot share with you. I'm sorry.
She's under arrest, but she's in protective custody right now. What is she in?
I would describe it as that she is in custody of law enforcement authorities during the pendency of an investigation. She is not charged with the crime at this point.
But she is in custody.
She is in custody and that we're transporting her to a hospital and there is the troopers will be accompanying her to the hospital.
Can you say your name again, sir?
David Procopio, P-R-O-C-O-P-I-O.
Did some sort of medical condition just come up recently in the past few hours? Because she came here and she didn't need to go to the hospital. She's been here for five and a half hours.
No, we're transporting her in response to information that's been developed. That's all. That's all I have to say. Thank you all.
Can you use the microphone later?
No, she's not. That's all. Thank you.